Hey everyone, I'm going to go over the latest features that were added to Summon in the latest version of 7.1 firmware. As you'll see on the new Summon screen, there's a new Customize button. If you click on the Customize button, you can actually do a couple more adjustments. Bumper clearance, as you can see, it has a nice little visual indication of how much room you should allow before the Summon stops from detecting a forward object. I'm going to leave that, let's say, at 16 inches. The other one I think is really important, at least in my case, is the summon distance. Originally, this defaulted to 39 feet. Let's see, it goes right to about 40 right now. And as you can see, that means when you hit the summon feature, it will back up 40 feet and then stop. If you do not push stop summon or you don't hit the center button on your key fob, the car will continue to roll out. My driveway is only about 29 feet long, so that actually means that if I do not do anything, the car will roll back into the street. What I really like about this feature is I can now go to, let's say, 23 feet. It will back out and actually stop before the end of the street. The other feature you've probably heard about is this requirement of a continuous press. What happened here is Consumer Reports apparently thought that it would be safer to have what's called a Deadman Switch, which is essentially you hold down the button on the key fob, you keep holding it down as the car is moving. If you let go or drop the key fob, the car stops. Tesla actually did something that I think is awesome. They allowed you to turn that feature on or off. So using this feature right here, I can actually require continuous press yes, or I could turn it off, in which case I'll have to answer to a little bit more of this legal disclaimer. I can hit yes, and then it works exactly as it did before. And I really like that aspect. The other really cool thing about this is when continuous press is off, it adds this feature where you double tap the parking button right here, right? And when you double tap it, I'm gonna demo it right now, it will automatically pull the car into the garage after you leave the car. So what I'm gonna do is turn this off right here. I'm gonna put the screen on so you can see what's going on. I'm going to double tap. And as you can see, it actually has this new interface that says auto park. It's showing me in blue that it's going to auto park forward. Watch what happens when I exit the car. It will automatically open the garage, pull in, and close the garage. Okay, so I'm out of the car right now. In the bottom right, you're seeing a view from my Blackview dash cam that's installed right behind the rearview mirror. And just to be 100% clear, I did not activate Summon using the key fob or an app. This is actually happening from double-clicking the parking button. That's the new feature that was just recently added in 7.1. This is a great little feature. I think it makes Summon a lot more useful because you can get out of the car in your driveway, carry a couple groceries, shut the door, and without having to fumble with your key fob or an app, automatically pulls right into your garage. It opens the garage door first, pulls in, closes the garage door, all completely without you in the car. It's pretty cool. So Tesla's giving a $1,200 credit for new Model S owners before April 15th, I believe. If you use the link below, the referral link below in the description, you can get that $1,200 credit when you purchase your Model S. You can use that, I believe, to help offset any costs involving installing a charger for your car. So it's a cool $1,200 value. If you find these videos useful and you think you can use that $1,200 credit, go ahead and click below. Otherwise, I will be back to demo some of the new features as they become available. Thanks a lot.